I would like to demonstrate how to load data inside R, and for that I have found a few data set here. So there is a data set here that we will try to load into R and try to work with. Usually it's actually a good habit of adding some names to the columns inside the file here. That'll make it easier for R to work with. So I just added this to this dataset01.csv file. So this is a comma-separated file. So we have two columns, and the columns are separated by this comma here. It's also possible to use other kinds of file formats here. But to read it in, we will use a function from the read_r package. And we could just rely on the read_csv file here, and then we need to specify the name for the data set. That, and actually we should be good to go here. So here we have our measurements that we just saved to a file here. So far, so good. And R tells us it has detected there are two columns present, one with the name X and one with the name Y, and they are all doubles. So far, so good. If we try to load one of the other data sets here, let's take a look here. They are not starting with X and Y, so we can't compare them that easily. So when we read that, it gives the two very unhelpful column names, so it would be nice if we could actually help it. So we can specify the column names, and we do that by putting them inside this C command with the name of each of the columns, so X and Y. So like this, and now we have these the values here. We can also see up here that we, in our current environment, we have this measurement variable containing 1,000 observations of two variables. Just clear it so we don't have clutter from earlier. So now we have the data, and we are able to put them inside a ggplot if that's what we want. So we need to specify the aesthetics. X will be X, and value on the Y coordinate will be the column Y, and we can say geom point and get the data plotted here. So it's some kind of damped oscillation. There's also a bit of noise on it. And in this case, it might make more sense to use a geom line, where we connect all the observations with a straight line. So this is what we are seeing here. And as a good habit, you should also put labels on the axis. So here we have the time in seconds, and on the white we have the amplitude, and that might be in millimeters or whatever measure we are trying to or unit we are trying to use here. And again, just to seem cloud plot like that. I think it's easier to look at. So now we have a plot, and we have something to continue working on. If you want to show multiple data sets in the same plot, there are two different approaches to that. Of course, we need to load the data set. I'll just try to demonstrate that part down here. Measurements one, like that, and we'll just continue. I know I have four data sets here. Like that, and then I want to combine them. Actually, I want to do something else first. I want to add information about where they origin from. So here we'll use the mutate command. command and say experiment 1 goes into this one, and we can actually see now it's 1001 observation of three arrivals. Let me see what's. Oh, it's doing something strange up here. That's where I actually specified the column names initially. Oh, that's better. And now I need to update this to 2, 3, and 4. So now I've loaded all the data sets, and we can try to take a look at how to actually plot this. What we have been used until now is to take our measurements we want to plot, pipe them into ggplot, and then specify what should be on the different axes. This, and then geom line. Now we have a plot. But it's also possible to specify this geom line and then state where should the data come from here. That could be from measurements 2. And now we have the two data sets shown in the same plot. Or yeah, we might as well just continue with data set 3 and 4, and to make these connect, I'll just use this plus between here. So now I have three or four different data sets plotted in the same coordinate system, but it's quite difficult to discriminate them between them. So let's see if we can add some colors to that. I hope one of those will turn red here, and we can. So now at least we can differentiate between the different plots here. Okay, what else are we missing to do here? Wait, yeah, there is a different and I think a slightly better way of doing this. And that consists of combining all the measurements, and for that there's a command named rbind, raw bind. Like that. So now I have this data with 4,000 observations of three variables. And we can see from what experiment they all are coming from. So now I can take all the measurements and pipe them through ggplot and specify that the aesthetics will again x to x, y to y, and the color would be from the experiment column. Now I should have more or less the same plot as before. With added a legend out here that explains what the 1, 2, 3, and 4 actually means. By default, this is sorted by or according to the alphabet. So we probably should change that in some way. And that's related to how we have data saved as a factor inside R. So let's see if we can clean this up a bit. In this case, we that should be updated using the factor command. And here I can give the labels in the order I want them to appear. Now I hope they appear in the right order. They do so here. So in this way, I'm able to aggregate all my data in a shootable data format and then throw them all at ggplot at a single time. So this was a bit on how to load data and then also plot the data afterwards.